Welcome to secondary steel making process. Today I am going to talk about iron oxidation, silicon oxidation and manganese oxidation. And by following the Raoult's law and Henry's law, how does oxygen dissolve and what is the content dissolved and how much iron is went out in the form of slag and such as manganese, silicon. So how do you know? So by applying the Raoult's law and Henry's law, you can calculate in terms of weight percentage and mole fraction. You can calculate by applying these two laws. Let us see iron oxidation. Iron in primary steel making, molten metal and oxygen, and gives rise during the primary steel making goes as FeO. So how does it occurs? What are the benefits? Let us try to know. For example, if this particular oxidation from the reaction 1, how do you control? There should be less iron content should go into the slag and more iron content should retain in the molten metal as steel form. So how do you control it? One thing is that this FeO content is slag form and oxygen content is there retaining in the steel. Even these two things are not favorable. How do you control? That means loss of iron is happening. So hence it affects the productivity, the yield of iron is low. So how do you control? It depends upon the oxidation potential of that particular FeO slag. How do you calculate? By applying the Raoult's law for these slags and Henry's law for this molten metal, dissolved iron and oxygen, you can calculate equilibrium constant with respect to the iron, activity of A of FeO and activity of iron and oxygen. And this particular activity of FeO and this Henrian activity of oxygen can be expanded in terms of when you apply the Henry's law, Henrian coefficient and weight percentage of oxygen. And further, this particular FeO can be calculated with log of FO and interaction parameter of Fe with O by substituting 0.1, you will be getting this thing. And these equations are available, thermodynamics equation for this kind of equation and free energy values in the form of A plus BT, A plus BT. So these things are available in the Ghost textbook, one can refer. And when you apply these two equations within this, finally you can expand like this by applying the weight percentage of oxygen and this 10 to the power of minus 0.07 weight percentage of oxygen and equal to this form A of FeO and log K of E. When you apply the log K of Fe and this is A plus BT and this is in the form of equation. When you solve, you can calculate the weight percentage of oxygen. At 1873, when you apply the temperature value and A of FeO assuming as a 1, you can calculate weight percentage of oxygen. How do you calculate? It means that these values, so when you try to calculate yourself and you will be getting this value, weight percentage of oxygen, from the previous problems which are explained, you can follow those steps and you can calculate. And at higher temperature, this is the dissolved oxygen in the molten steel after secondary steel making process. It means that the dissolution of oxygen in this steel can be controlled with respect to the temperature. At higher temperature, it will be more dissolution of oxygen. And similarly, with respect to these are the few of the interaction parameter values with respect to the elements are given. So one can refer and one can substitute in the equations with the form of all these elements are given. So you can refer. Now let me talk about oxidation of silicon. Is nothing but desiliconization. This is the silicon in the molten steel after primary steel making. This is the oxygen dissolved in the after primary steel making. This is SiO2. Silicon is going out in the form of slag. When you apply the Henry's law and Raoult's law, you can rewrite with the equilibrium constant of silicon A of SiO2 by weight percentage of silicon and weight percentage of oxygen square. And when you apply these things, you can rewrite, rearrange these things. These are the two values in the form of A plus BT from the different sources, different thermodynamics calculation of textbook references are shown here. You can apply one of them and you can calculate the weight percentage of oxygen. And the conclusion, these both equations gives an idea that the decrease in temperature increases the K, since it is the inverse. K of Si is proportional to inverse temperature. And there is a slight difference. When you use these two parameters, you will realize this 15 equation predicts that around 15 to 70% higher equilibrium constant of silicon than the 16. So that also one can realize what are the favorable temperature less silicon should retain in the molten steel. So it happens at a lower temperature, and if this activity of silicon is low in slag, and mainly basic slag favors silicon going out in the form of slag. And what it happens in the basic slag is this SiO2 value oxidation, it reacts with the FeO of basic slag and decrease activity of silica, so that this in the form with combining the basic slag, silicon will go out, and amount of silicon retained in the steel after refining process, after secondary steel making, is becomes low. And it means that this silicon is also an effective deoxidizer. If further necessary, the silicon need to be added for the few applications for improving the machine reliability and all those physical properties, you can add in the form of ferrosilicon. It happens during the secondary steel making process. Please make a note. Now let me talk about oxidation of manganese. This iron carbon melt in case of steel, how does it occurs? It is known that the manganese and iron are very less difference of atomic number. It easily dissolve in the iron with any proportion. So that is one of the physical property, and in ideal solution form it makes. That's why Raoult's inactivity is, it follows the Raoult's law, straight line. So as I explained in the Raoult's law, so it doesn't show positive deviation, negative deviation, it follows the ideal. And if carbon is there in the steel, it immediately reacts with the manganese, it forms manganese carbide, or at lower temperature it may form MnO, MnO2, MnO3. So it means in these forms this Mn goes out in the form of slag. The Mn retention so will be very less in the molten steel after refining process. Assume that this is a one equation, and molten in hot metal manganese, in hot metal oxygen, and goes out MnO as slag form. And there is another situation, again this particular MnO slag and Mn in the hot metal, there is a FeO, it reacts and it goes out MnO form again. And this iron also, there is a loss. So this reactions is nothing but this reaction is this much amount of oxygen is dissolved, and this particular reaction is metal and with slag metal reaction. So what are the properties, how do you deal with these things? Most of the cases the reaction is exothermic, the heat is evolved, heat dissipated. At lower temperature this reaction is favor, at higher temperature this reaction, that means some of the manganese is retaining, is nothing but reversal of manganese in the steel. And coming to this, applying the thermodynamics, Raoult's law and Henry's law, for these two equations you will realize that this is a slag metal reaction, this is pure oxygen dissolved in the molten metal. When you apply the Raoult's law, this For this equation, k of mno by k of mn into k of mo write down in the side. And for this reaction, this is a equilibrium constant. A of mno and A of FeO by, since it is a molten metal dissolved, it is H of mno and slag A of FeO. And it can be rearranged since it A of FeO is equal to 1, so it is simplified. And this particular thing is, since A of mno is slag form, it is expanded like this as per the Raoult's law, gamma I into xi, gamma I into xi. Similarly for the FeO also, gamma I into xi. And since it is the endless law, it is also expanded. Since there are activity coefficient of Raoult's activity coefficient, Henry's activity coefficient, grouping all these things together, it is need to be assumed that the mole fraction of MNO is equal to Raoult's law and Henry's law becomes equal at equilibrium temperature. Then you can rewrite this K is nothing but with respect to this equation. You can simplify, only final it removes, retain with this another new equilibrium constant K star. You can rearrange like this. And finally, these things need to be sorted out. There are more explanation in the Ayendra Ghosh textbook. You can refer back. And finally, with slag form MN and with FeO and Henry N activity, manganese, you can come out with this equation. And this FeO, if you take out, you can come out simplified to finally this equation. This equation is coming from A plus BFT form, it is given. And using these equations, let us solve one of the numerical problem. And about the manganese, it is suggested that at lower temperature, K star, as is explained here, K star is increases. And activity of FeO with MnO is oxidizing slag nature. And with respect to the temperature, it is clearly understood at lower temperature, so maximum amount of K star, so manganese is retained, most of the manganese is retained there. At higher temperature, manganese is very less, MnO. Consider this numerical problem. The slag basicity having 1.8, at this basicity, the activity coefficient of MnO, AMnO in slag is 1.6. X mole fraction of FeO and MnO are 0.25 and 0.05 respectively. Determine the equilibrium content of manganese and oxygen by from the slag metal reaction. This is also given data. Mn plus FeO gives rise MnO slag, and Fe is retaining the steel. Droplets form, metal is also going out. And when you apply the equilibrium constant definition, so LnK with respect to the manganese, delta J is equal to minus RT LnK. And from this equation, from the previous slide, so you can rewrite this K star value. And by using this K star value, when you substitute the temperature, all other parameters, by assuming the A of FeO and A of Fe naught from the problem, so you can, by substituting A of FeO and MnO values within this thing, you will be getting percentage of manganese is equal to 0.048. Similarly, with respect to this equation, you can also calculate the weight percentage of oxygen from this equation. It becomes, from this equation, by assuming the log of K star equal to this much, it converts this thing. And although it may looks like shortcut for you, try to solve yourself. These are the very important for the gate examination. Unless until you solve yourself, I was explaining, but you will be getting to some percentage. When you solve yourself in the notebook, you will be getting the more and more clarity. Weight percentage of oxygen is equal to this much. This is given, weight percentage of oxygen, and AF FeO is also given in the problem. So finally, you will be getting the weight percentage of saturated one, and saturated value also is given, this AFEO. From this equation you are calculating the saturation 1.3 equation. This AFFEO is equal to weight percentage of oxygen. So as the coefficients in the Raoult's law and Lindt's law, this is the one more assumption. And you realize that at lower temperature around 1773 Kelvin, the manganese is 0.032 at 0.7732, and at this particular 1873 this much value. And as the temperature is decreases, the manganese from metal to slag is decreasing, and you can try to solve for 1973. Again you can interpret that further decrease from this particular table it is witness 1923, 1873. This is for the temperature of 1873. This manganese is 1873 and this value is 1773. Solve yourself, you will be getting the manganese weight percentage of manganese value this much. Now think about how to calculate the amount of oxygen dissolved in hot metal after refining, after secondary steel making process, and how much silicon and manganese, iron removed as form of slag. How do you calculate these things? Where these Raoult's law and Henry's law are much useful, and those things can be cleared by solving these laws and thermodynamics equations. Thank you.